Hey man, I know you came here to promote your magazine, but brother, I was supposed to have a relationship expert on this morning to talk about why men cheat. She called the last minute and canceled. I wanted to run with the topic, tied into happily single. Brother, look, you make this interesting, Derek, I will promote your magazine for free. Can you handle that?
No doubt. You ain't said nothing but a word. Free.
Cool.
The fact that she lets him get away with it makes it possible for him to get away with it again. You see, women are not stupid.
Right.
They know when they're dealing with a dog, but they ignore the obvious signs. Because they're either too whipped or too comfortable in the relationship to do anything about it. Now tell me I'm wrong.
Hey, can't say you wrong, but check this out. My producer, this happens to be a woman. She tells me, she says, Justin, look, I got a master's degree. I got my own house, my own car, and my own money. My man would never cheat on me. That's exactly what I told her, brother. Looks like we need to go to the phone line. We probably struck a nerve with this one this morning. WATL, you're on with DJ Justin. Karen, go ahead.
Kiki, get out that refrigerator. Hello? Oh, hey, listen, I just have one thing to say. I agree with Jerry 100%. Women do know when they're dating him. I probably would. Because see, at this point in my life, I'm too busy working and going to school to be bothered with a full-time relationship. Now, a little maintenance every now and then would do me just fine.
Would you reserve the right to sleep with other men?
Damn right I would. Oh, I'm sorry, I ain't mean to curse. Go sit your ass down. See, honey, I want the same freedom in the relationship as he does. What's good for the goose is good for the gander.
Sounds like you've answered your own question.
What do you mean?
I mean, we all know the reason that men lie to women about being committed is to keep them from having sex with other men. Let's face it, men are too greedy and too insecure to share their women.
A little bit about the play and your character.
The play's about Derek Reed, young brother, you know, entrepreneur, you know, just doing his thing. You know, he actually is a corporate brother that has this desire to leave corporate America and start his own business, have his own magazine. And because of that, he winds up going through some trials and tribulations in his relationship with his father. Then he meets a woman, falls in love. That's a tumultuous relationship. You know, and the brother just, he was a player prior to that. The magazine is happily single, so, you know, he's the kind of guy that's serious about being single. Then he falls in love, and, you know, I don't want to give the whole play away.
How does this relate to your real life?
Not at all, in any way. Just the fact that I'm single. That's it.
What do you take from the, what do you think that people are taking from this play, or what would you like for them to take from it?
I mean, just come enjoy it. You know, I mean, we all have, you know, our different stages in our lives. Some people can relate because they've been in a situation similar at some point. Some people may be in a situation like that right at this moment. You know, so you never know. You know, sometimes some people may be about to embark on a situation that may be similar in a relationship that they're in now. Just the whole thing is about relationships. So it isn't about one specific topic. It's about my relationship with my friends, my relationship with my dad, the girlfriend that I have. Then I, you know, I wind up messing that up.
You
know? Huh?
No, you gotta talk.
I gotta talk.
So he's pretty cool?
Real good guy, real good guy. Nice guy. I hadn't known anything about his books prior to them asking me to do this, but it's been a lot of fun.